from Pacific Grow. Continuing coverage on that seagull situation they've had. Today, city leaders announced they've come up with what could be a solution to all the mess that the birds leave on the sidewalks, streets, and just about everywhere else. Action News reporter May Chow is live at our Salinas newsroom with their sort of plan of attack, May.
Dan, some respite, a little bit of respite for Pacific Grove residents who say they've had enough with the seabirds and the flock of problems they're leaving behind.
I had a gull fly into my building. I mean, chasing me around my freaking building. So it was like, man.
I watched a gull actually stealing food out of the person's food basket that they were sitting there at a table eating.
Depending on who you ask, Pacific Grove has gone to the birds, and it's ruffling some feathers in America's last hometown. But residents aren't taking this sitting down or quietly.
I mean, we don't have much time. I mean, these roofs are like nasty.
I don't think the city can afford to keep this situation going.
With the gulls raising stink and drying ire of residents, city leaders held a Seagull Summit Friday morning to address the problem. And for the dozens who turned out, some good news. The city is altering its illegal discharge ordinance so some residents and businesses can begin pressure washing without fear of being fined for water pollution. This is all thanks to a new diversion system which runs wastewater bound for the Monterey Bay through a filter.
Being right here by the Monterey Bay Sanctuary, we know we're limited as to our ability to wash down streets, and so a lot of people, I think, have chosen not to do anything because they don't want to do anything that's going to, you know, pollute the bay.
So if someone wants to pressure wash, they must call Public Works first to see if they're in a designated area and if the system is operating, as it only runs during dry weather months.
It's really imperative that we do something to mitigate the situation and to clean up the situation.
What the long-term solution would be, you know, it sounds like we're not the only ones who maybe don't have that figured out. But the issue really isn't the seagulls. I mean, they, you know, they add a nice coastal feel for it. It's you know, the byproducts of the seagulls.
And property owners are responsible for their own cleaning costs, but the city says it will work to come up with a joint cleaning effort with the merchants. Dan?
All right. Thanks very much. Appreciate it, May. Many people say the gulls aren't really so much the problem. It's the tourists and the people, the other people who feed them. They are protected under the Migratory Bird Treaty Act.